Melissa from Melissa at Home, and welcome back to another video. It's so good to be back and to be in front of you guys on camera again. So in this video, I'm going to talk about social anxiety and working from home, how you can, you know, balance it out while trying to get over the hump of having social anxiety. Okay, so I'm going to share some opportunity for those who have requested for the types of jobs that work for those who have social anxiety, and I'm going to, you know, share some advice, some tips, just my personal opinion in regards to, you know, working from home, especially if you have social anxiety again. So I'm going to get into that in a moment. Firstly, I wanted to give a shout out to Julia online jewelry store. They sent me this beautiful personalized necklace. It has my name as well as my birthstone, which is a ruby. They create personalized jewelry. They have other different types of jewelry that they have on their websites that are absolutely beautiful, guys, and they're highly affordable. It's well-made jewelry. You can have a personalized necklace with your name, and this says Melissa going around. It has the letter M-E-L-E-C-I-A going around the necklace, and it has my birthstone again in the center. So I'm not sure if you guys can see it. It's very beautiful and well-made, high-quality jewelry that they create, and they'll send you a catalog of other jewelries that they sell on their website. If you go on their website, you'll see all their collections that they make. If you're interested in having a similar necklace like this where you get your name, personalized name, as well as your birthstone, I'll post a link to it below this video along with their online store. So definitely check out Julia. I absolutely love this necklace so much, and it's a trendy necklace. They also have jewelry that are trending, and I believe personalized necklaces are trending nowadays, so I had to grab me one. So again, I'll post a link below this video to their store so you can check it out. And of course, Valentine's Day is approaching, so it'll be a great place to shop for a special someone. They also have like wedding bands and engagement rings. If you have a special someone that you're looking to propose to, definitely check out Julia. They have very affordable jewelry, okay? All right, so let's get into the video talking about social anxiety. That is something that is close to home for me. I, at one point, suffered from social anxiety. Now, social anxiety is something that has to be, I believe it has to be diagnosed by a professional, like people who actually can diagnose it. So it's not something that you just go around labeling people to have. There are people who consider themselves to be introverts. Now, there is a difference. Being an introvert is more of a trait. It's like a character trait that you have, and there's nothing wrong with being an introvert. Introverts tend to have some balance, like they are able to interact with people. They still will talk to people. It's just that we are more so concerned about being in a large crowd. We prefer to be in a smaller crowd, but we still like to interact with people. But at the same time, we like to be alone, and we don't have a problem with being by ourselves and enjoying our time with ourselves, right? So that's totally different from having social anxiety. Those who have social anxiety, it's connected with mental health. You may think, like, you know, you're being criticized for every little thing that you do. If you're in a crowd, you feel like people are staring at you or looking at your flaws, or, you know, you may fear talking to people because you're not sure if what you say will sound dumb, and so you avoid crowds or social events or anything that has to do with interacting with any other human being as much as possible, okay? So that can be considered social anxiety. And of course, there are different levels. There's those who suffer from it severely. Now, I do get contacted by people who desire to work from home and they don't want to interact with people, and they do admit that they suffer from social anxiety. So that's just my area. My area is sharing work from home jobs. I'm not a psychologist and I'm not a therapist or anything like that, okay? But I can relate in a way, because I, at one point, again, suffered from that, and I feel like it hindered me from accomplishing a lot of things. I believe that I missed out on some amazing opportunities because I turned down, you know, speaking engagements, and it could have taken my business to the next level. So that's something that I had to work through and really sit down and say, you know, I don't want this to hold me back from my full potential. So I want you guys to not allow your fears to hold you back from your full potential. So I'm going to share some opportunities that I want you to also consider. Yes, these opportunities will be talking about, you know, interacting with people a little bit, because I believe that it's very important to have a balance, okay? Working from home is great. There are some benefits for working from home, but for those who suffer from social anxiety, it may elevate it and make it worse, okay? So again, if you're someone who's trying to combat social anxiety and you're working towards moving away from it and curing yourself from it, then again, you definitely want to have a balance where you can interact with individuals and interact with people, okay? And also, if you do work from home, there are other individuals that may be around your area that work from home too, so you can connect with people that share the same commonality with you, and you'll be amazed at how much you may have in common with them. And you can, you know, socialize, go out to events together, go to the movies, go to a concert. Just make sure that you're getting out and about with other individuals. So that's basically my take on that. You don't want this thing to hinder you and limit you from your potential. Those who suffer from social anxiety also have some great skills and abilities and natural sense of nurturing, caring for others. They're great listeners, they're thinkers, and so they do really well in fields that actually interact with other people. They can be counselors, they can have consultation services, they can work as in management positions. You know, those types of people do well because they can relate with other people, they're nurturing, they're understanding, they have great listening skills. There are people out there that like to be listened to, and you can offer that to people. You don't have to talk a lot. And I found that out throughout my journey as an introvert and at one point suffering from social anxiety, that people like to talk to me and share their personal information with me. And at one point, you know, someone called me their personal diary. They just felt so comfortable, you know, opening up to me. And they felt as though I was someone they can trust, that I would not judge them. And that is my personality, okay? So people who do suffer from social anxiety have that really great quality where they can, you know, implement into the work field and interact with people. So you don't want to limit yourself. Know that there are people out there that need those skills and natural abilities that you have, and you're like preventing them from gaining access to you. People want to be close to you, they want to know more about you, but you're like, oh, I don't want to be close to them because I have these flaws, I don't like the way I look, they're gonna see this flaw that I have, I'm not well spoken, I don't speak well, I use the wrong terms, I may say something that may make them look at me like I'm dumb and I don't know what I'm talking about. But again, I'm just gonna share some work from home opportunities for those who do suffer from it, and I'm gonna, you know, give you some suggestions to other types of opportunity that I feel will help to balance you out and do provide some interaction with other people to, you know, help you to overcome those fears and, you know, do not limit your skills and your ability, okay? So definitely, of course, the types of work from home jobs that you would consider and look into is writing. You could be a writer if you're really good at writing. I know that people with social anxiety are people who think a lot, so they have a very creative imagination and a great creative mind, and they tend to be excellent writers. They could write novels and books and stories and poems and all of that. I wrote tons of poetry, okay? I love poetry and I love writing, I love reading, all of that stuff. So you can earn additional income as a reader, you know, being a book reviewer, okay? So you can look into doing book reviews. You can do writing jobs such as, you know, writing articles for bloggers, writing for online magazines. There's so many different fields in writing that you can go into, and I highly suggest that you look into, you know, creating your own freelance independent contracting business where you could provide services for your skill and get paid for your skills. And again, in writing, you can also look into proofreading jobs. You can, you know, actually take courses online to be a proofreader. You can look into some virtual assistant type of work. There are certain aspects of being a virtual assistant that allows you to, you know, work independently. You could do graphic design. If you're good at designing, you can design websites, you can design apps, you could design labels for products and so forth. You could come up with invention ideas and sell your ideas, which I talked about in another video. So there's a lot of areas you could go into that does not require you to interact with other people, okay? You could be a blogger. There are successful bloggers out there that are making substantial amounts of money just blogging and sharing their website, and you can get into that as well. You can also make a YouTube channel. You'd be amazed at how many people who are doing YouTube who have social anxiety. I was one of them. Now I just deal with being an introvert, okay? There's a lot of introverts, and there's a lot of people who suffer from social anxiety who have successful YouTube channel, okay? So you could definitely do YouTube, and YouTube is great to do as well, because at some point you will reach a level where you would have to balance it out, where you have to go out on speaking engagements and meet up with people and meet other YouTubers and interact with them and so forth. So if you are considering being a YouTuber, then definitely go for it, okay? Yes, you will be criticized, and I know I'm telling you to jump into the water with sharks. As someone who suffered from social anxiety, it could be a lot for you. And I know a lot of people who quit YouTube when they were doing really well, but that one comment just caused them to shut down YouTube because they suffer from social anxiety and they, you know, had flaws, and that one person may pick up on that flaw and highlight it, and instead of just delete, block, and move on, the numerous amount of people that were supporting them, that loved what they did, they focused on that one negative comment. And again, social anxiety is connected to mental health. So it's all about your mind. It's all in your mind. So if you could get that together, then you'll be good. You will be great, okay? And again, those who suffer from social anxiety have so much to offer. I believe they are the most sensitive, caring, giving, loving people there ever was. And they have so much to offer. You have so much to offer. So don't let that stop you, okay? It is something that you can get over. So moving forward to opportunities that you can do, you know, if you suffer from social anxiety, again, blogging, writing, proofreading, web designing. You could sell items if you, again, creative individual, you like to create items. You could sell products on Etsy, on different websites such as eBay. You know, you could create your own marketplace and sell your handmade goods if you like to create things and you don't have to interact with people at all. Even if you don't create items or you know how to make jewelry or make things and you're not into that, you can look into drop shipping and sell products on eBay and just have drop ship products to your customers, and you don't have to deal with that. You just collect your commission, okay? So there's tons of opportunities available. Notice that majority of them do require you to actually be independent and be a freelancer and more in the entrepreneurial area. Yes, okay, yeah. So that's basically where you would have to go, okay? So again, there's tons of opportunity for you. Now, if you're someone who suffers from social anxiety and you're working with a therapist or you're working with someone, some professional to help you to move out of it, then again, I want to encourage you to continue to do so, because there's a world of amazing opportunities out there for you, and you don't want to hinder yourself from these opportunities because you have a lot to offer, okay? So the types of opportunities that you can excel in is being a counselor, providing consultation in different areas that you're knowledgeable about. If it's cooking, if it's designing, interior designing, picking out the best fashion and so forth, you can provide consultation service in that area and get paid for it as well. You can also succeed in managerial positions as well. Go for it, yes. What you feel is human, okay? We all have flaws. We all have struggles and within ourselves and within our minds. That allows us to connect with other people. So definitely don't think that you're limited to doing writing and proofreading and typing jobs and data entry work, so you don't have to talk to people. You're missing out on so many opportunities. You could be a speaker. You could stand in front of a crowd and speak to people. You can be a counselor. You can provide consultation services. You could be a manager. You could work in areas that actually help people, help animals, help the earth, I don't know. You know, you can do so much. So again, I don't want you to limit yourself and just stay in your comfort zone, in your shell. Again, I'm not a psychologist and I don't have a degree in any of thing that has to do with social anxiety, but I can personally relate to it because I at one point suffered from it, and I know that it's something that I had to push my way through. And even to this day, I still shy away from speaking engagement. I've been invited to numerous speaking engagement and to do collaborations with other YouTubers to speak to their audience, and I turned it down because I felt insecure about, I don't know, what am I gonna say to these people? What if I mess up? What if I sound stupid? What if I, da, da, da? You know, it's just like all in your head. So you have, it's like a battle that you're fighting, and you can come out victoriously, okay? So again, do not limit yourself. And I just wanna encourage you that there's so many opportunities out there for you, and don't just think that they're just for certain types of people. There for you as well. All right, so that's basically all I want to share with you guys. I just want to come on here and encourage you, those who have contacted me. And if you work from home, you can, again, sure there are other people in your area that also work from home, and you can connect with them and get together with them and, you know, just go out and have a good time and talk about work from home and, you know, all the things you have to deal with, and just bond, you know, create a bond with each other, okay? All the links and information will be posted below as usual. If someone you know, if they suffer from social anxiety, you know, definitely share this video and encourage them and be there for them and help them to get through it. And I'll see you guys next time. Happy work from home. Bye-bye.